Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty, Artcast 563. I'm doing some drawing today, but I want to show you guys this before I did anything else. Got something in the mail. All this stuff is from Scott Circlin. Since I was talking about Indiegogo and Kickstarter and all that kind of thing, I thought I'd show you guys his book. He had a Kickstarter running, I think, maybe 2 months ago. I'm going to go check that real quick. Looks like it funded on April 10th. And it's June 5th, so April, May, June. So that's like 2 months. 2 months to fulfill this Kickstarter. And that's how you do it. That's how you do it, man. It's impressive, and it looks like a great book. You know, and I tell you, it's how you get customers. You know what I mean? You get customers by delivering what you promise. You know, you see a lot of, you know, Kickstarters and stuff that take like a year. Like my first Kickstarter was just pathetic. I hate to even, you know, ever bring it up and mention it. It took me a year to get the books out. I had all kinds of trouble. But I learned a lot. You know, I learned a ton. And I learned not to ever do that again. You know what I mean? I learned to make sure when I got that money that I could print my books, get them sent out, and all that kind of stuff. I think he told me he printed this with, I'm trying to think what it was, Comics Wellspring. I'm pretty sure. Which it's a nice comic. I mean, it's got a decently thick cover, which I put a thick cover on mine too. Mine's a little bit different kind of thickness though. I'd say mine's a hair more thick. I kind of wish I wouldn't have though. That was something I thought I wanted, and then I got it, and, you know. But this is a decent cover. It almost feels like it might have some lamination or something. And the inside's kind of a, it doesn't look glossy. It's a black and white book, of course. Sorry, I'm holding it down off the camera. I should get it up this way. It's not a real glossy look. It's more of a matte kind of finish, sort of like what I got in my art books. It's a nice, I mean, it looks good with the black and white art for sure. But I'm looking for another printer for my next book because my printer went out of business. So he also sent along this, which I'm pretty sure he threw this in as an extra because I think I just backed for the comic. Or maybe it was some stretch goals. I don't know. But that's kind of a cool thing too. People love getting extra free stuff, things they didn't expect. I know I got a lot of compliments for sending out my postcards once my Indiegogo got funded. And what's this, like a sticker? My son will love that. I'm sure he'll put that somewhere. And some 3D glasses for this print. Let's check this out. Let's see if Scott actually knows what he's doing. Oh yeah, that thing's super 3D. Yeah, that's pretty neat. Here it is. You guys can check it out. Very cool. And right here, another one. Gave me another zombie sticker. I heart zombies with a heart. Cool. Great package. Great package. Super satisfied with that. Thanks, Scott. So today I am working on that piece I drew the other day, the punch out piece where he's punching out this zombie, throwing down some color on this baby, and getting it done, getting on to the next piece, which is getting on to the next piece which is getting close to, you know, finishing up this animated intro thing, and I'm looking forward to that. You know, I was thinking about drawing in general, like learning how to draw. I get a lot of questions about, you know, how to draw. It's kind of like beginning questions of like how to do stuff, you know what I mean? And you know, like with me, like how I learned how to draw, you know, if you really went back and saw the young Jeff Lafferty living out on the prairies of Colorado and suddenly deciding that he was going to be an artist for whatever reason. You know, it was all back to comics. It was all back to basically buying comics at the, you know, gas station at first, at the, you know, like the corner store kind of gas station. I'm old enough. It was, you know, four for a dollar, you know, a quarter for a comic. And, you know, that was just like my thing. I'd just, you know, be following my dad around. And when we get to a gas station, he'd just give me a buck and I'd buy four comics. And it was kind of funny because I remember, I mean, this is kind of a side thing, but, you know, like my dad rodeoed when I was a kid. And I remember, like, I'd love that because when we'd go far away, you know, there's like different gas stations. You know what I mean? So you get to like a different place and you'd find different comics. Like I'll never forget it. I think we were down in, I mean, it could have been just Southern Colorado, but I almost want to say it was Texas. And we went to this diner place to eat and they had comics in there, you know, a spinner rack with some comics. So of course I went over there and all the comics on there were like, were different. There was no like Marvel DC comics on there. And they were like religious comics and stuff, you know, like religious comics, like history comics. And I remember like looking through them and not finding any kind of like superhero kind of thing, or like Tarzan was like a big one that I used to like to buy back then. There was like no Tarzans, but there was this one, the Iliad, you know, like the Iliad, the Greek poem. There was like an adaptation of the Iliad. And I remember buying that one. And then I think there was a, this one that was like an adaptation of like the Bible, and Joe Cooper actually did it. He was like the artist on Tarzan. I remember buying that one and thinking they were so cool because they were just unusual, you know. And I also remember the ads in the comics were different. You know, it was like, you know, you had those standard ads with the X-ray glasses and all that kind of stuff in the back, but these comics had like different ads. It was weird. I don't know. I guess I could look it up on the internet and try to figure out, you know, who published those things back in the day, but it's just weird, you know, it's just like whole different kind of comics. And it wasn't like, you know, down there they didn't have the normal comics. You know, you'd go into gas stations, you'd see like the normal comics. But this set of comics and this spinner rack was just an oddball kind of deal that we found someplace. But anyway, that's where I learned how to draw was just copying panels from those comics. And so as time went on and I got better at drawing, you know, and started to kind of draw my own comics, I would just reference those comics, you know what I mean? I was using them like an anatomy book. I would like look at those comics and see like how somebody was standing or how somebody's arms went or hands went or whatever. And then I would draw like my version of that. And I would also like look how the lines went, like how certain ink lines make shape. And I'd copy that, and that's how I learned how to, like, you know, make my figures look more real and stuff. And when I went to art school, I didn't go to art school for very long, but I went for like a semester or something when I got out of high school. I just didn't really know, you know, where do you go to be an artist. And I remember my high school guidance counselor was like, you know, go to art school. And so I went to this art school that was in Colorado here, but it was more like an advertising school. So I really wasn't, you know, going for what I thought I wanted to go for. So I ended up dropping out after a semester because I was hot to get into comics, you know. You know, when you're young, you know, you don't got time for waiting around. You got that laser beam vision on what you want to do, and you feel like any amount of time not doing it is just time wasted. So anyway, that was the attitude I had. And so I ended up leaving school. But I was going to say, like, when I went into college, though, you know, you immediately start drawing from life, you know, life drawing sessions where you're drawing from a nude model. But I noticed, you know, out of the class that I was in, there was a couple other guys that were sort of like influenced by comics early on. And once we got into the life drawing classes, I noticed that we had like an easier time of it, drawing from life, drawing the anatomy, all that kind of stuff. We were like a lot better at it than a lot of people in the class. And, you know, I'm convinced that like that was because of that early study of like comics, because, you know, most of the costumes and stuff are kind of like these like skin tight things, and you're basically just drawing anatomy because you're drawing all the muscles and stuff. And it was just a great place to like learn that kind of thing, you know. So anyway, back to like the point of this whole thing, like when people ask me, how do you learn this stuff, you know, how do you get good at art, things like that, I kind of, you know, a lot of times I'll tell them that story, but like my point when I tell them that story is that learning aspect of it. I don't think you have to learn it from comics, but if you're going to do, you know, good figures and good anatomy and that kind of stuff, you have to learn it somewhere. So it has to be either anatomy books, it has to be from life, you know, it has to be from some kind of reference photos, because like those sorts of things, you know, like how the bones work, how the muscles work, has to be like learned from somewhere. So the learning part of it is like huge, you know. And that's just the basis, I think, of art. It's like a mixture of the creative and also like the learned, you know what I mean? So when you need to learn something, you go around, you find somebody that's doing it well, and you watch how they do it, you know, then you go back to the studio and practice what they do. And then when you find somebody else that's doing something else good that you like, you study what they're doing, you bring it back to the studio, practice it, and then you add it into the mix, you know what I mean? And as time goes on, like when you're a young student, you sort of wear your influences on your sleeve and everybody can kind of tell who you're looking at and who you're studying and things like that. But as time goes on, that mix gets more, there's a lot more variety in there. And it all kind of becomes your style along with like your own take on it, you know, your own creativity. So I think like learning and studying is just a crucial part of getting good at art. You can't really skip over that part. And it's just something I think I've just kind of carried through my whole life with my own work. It's just like, you know, continually like study the stuff that you like and try to bring in the best stuff that you see into your own work. And I think it works well. Anyway, there you guys go. That's it for today. Berserkonaut is over at Indiegogo. It's in demand still, so you can actually just go buy one today. I'll send it to you tomorrow, all that good stuff. The mailing list is down in the description if you guys want to sign up. In case you're not getting notifications from YouTube about my new videos going up, I'll just send you a notification. And Patreon, if you appreciate the videos I do, then go over to Patreon. See you guys next time.